Well, this is May 22nd, 2012, and our guests are the Hartles, Dr. and Mrs. Hartle. We appreciate you giving us your time to be able to do this interview. Thank you very much.
Hey, you're welcome.
Doctor, let's start with you. A little bit about your personal background, where you grew up, what your mother and father did, brothers and sisters.
Okay, well, I was born in Hardin County on a farm. It was where three counties come together, Hardin, Marion, and Wyandotte. We lived in Hardin County. Our mailbox was in Marion County across the road, on the opposite side of the road. And I went to school in Wyandotte County, which was at Marsales, which is 3 miles from our house, which came up, actually, the county probably was only about a mile from the house, the edge of the county line. So grew up on a farm. My father had a poultry farm, and he had a hatchery. And my job was to collect the eggs. So I never really cared that much for eggs. Although I can eat them all right. I just never got to where I liked them. I do like chicken. But I helped on the farm. And I got interested in medicine. I'm not sure really why, except that I just like to know how things tick. I had said that I might have been an engineer, and my mother said that I always wanted to run a junkyard. But
you were a collector.
I was always interested in junkyard. Yeah, I collected things. I still collect things. But point that I think I got interested was when I helped our veterinarian do a bowel surgery on a cow that had an obstructed bowel. I think it was an intussusception or rotated bowel, something. I can't remember exactly what it was, but I helped him do the surgery. And they resected a part of the colon of the bowel. Of the cow. Cow didn't make it, but, or at least not, she may have made it through the surgery and all, but I know it died later. But that was the really first contact I actually had in doing anything and from a medical standpoint. But I decided I didn't want to be a veterinarian. I'd rather go into people medicine.
So maybe that was the first spark?
I think it may have been. I mean, I think the only other thing that I can think of was just my curiosity. I mean, some people say that they really were like to help people. I don't know if that was really my stimulus. But, and so I really can't pinpoint any one thing.
That's pretty interesting. And anything else that came into second place in terms of what you might thought?
You mean pushing
career?
Me into medicine? No, I don't think so. Except I didn't want to live. I didn't want to go stay on the farm. I had enough hard work on the farm when I was a kid, and so my sister had gone to Ohio State and graduated in home ec. And so that's where I went to school, and pre-med. And my dad had a poultry farm, and he raised turkeys to send my sister through school. I dressed turkeys and sold them at Thanksgiving and Christmas. And so they did the same thing for me when I went to undergrad school and pre-med. And I remember selling turkeys. I'd take them down to Columbus and sell them at some of the restaurants around the university there. I don't know if you knew of Prasuti's restaurant out on West 5th Avenue. And we sold them turkeys for their restaurant and Thanksgiving and Christmas. the first time, my dad used to go to deliver chickens to Columbus or near Columbus. I remember when I was, it was probably around 1940, 41. I would have been about 9 years old. And I remember going with him, maybe it was later than that, I don't know, but it was in the early 40s, to taking boxes of chickens, baby chicks, to Columbus. And I remember seeing the Leveque Lincoln Tower, which at that time, it didn't seem very far away. I mean, it couldn't have been more than a half mile, I wouldn't think, or maybe a mile, but it seemed awfully close. And of course, now, wherever that farm was, would be part of Columbus, I'm sure, or be all built up. And he also sold baby chicks to George Byers, who ran Byers' automotive thing. He had chickens in layers in cages that would collect the eggs as they rolled out, and it was quite a setup. And my dad sold him chickens.
When did you begin medical school?
I graduated from high school in 1950 and went to Ohio State. I applied for medical school on a 3-year medical program for after the end of 3 years pre-med. I applied for medical school. It was on a program that was set up that way. But I didn't get into medical school in 3 years. I went back to and asked, Ronald Thompson was the auditor, and he's the one that, I think there were two people that came in my interview. And I wondered why I didn't get in. I went back and asked him. I had good grades. He said, well, we just thought you'd go another year. Of course, I was probably one of the youngest in my class. I was born in November, and at that time you didn't have to wait another year. You went, and I started school when I was only 5 years old, I guess. So the next year I applied again for Ohio State, and I also applied for Case Western Reserve and Johns Hopkins. And I hadn't even gotten a reply, I don't think, from them, or at least I'm not even real sure I sent in the formal application. I know I got applications. And I went back to Ohio State for another interview, and all they did was ask me what I did during the summer. Said you'd be in the medical school. And it was same Ronald Thompson that gave me that interview. And so I started medical school, and I graduated in undergrad in 54, and we were married then in September 54, and I started in just a couple of weeks after we were married.
Wow. And residency where?
Well, I took, in my senior year of medical school, I was in this Army or military senior medical student program for the military. So I was on active duty during my senior year of medical school, paid second lieutenant's pay. And then I applied for internship at Brook Army Hospital. Actually, I applied at Brook and Tripler in Hawaii and Washington, D.C., Walter Reed in Washington, D.C. Of course, the one I got was Brook Army Hospital in San Antonio. It was nice, but it would have been nice to go to Hawaii, but but I didn't get that.
Yeah.
Anyway, I spent a year in at Brook, then on my internship. And when I finished the internship, I had to take the basic military training for, I don't know, 3 months, I guess it was. Or maybe it's just a month, I don't know, for medical officers. And then went into a preventive medicine program to be a preventive medicine officer. And I think that was 2 or 3 months program. And at that time, then she was expecting our second child. And so we got a deferment, and during for being transferred out to Europe. And so I worked in the Fort Sam Houston dispensary for 3 months until after she delivered. And so when in early January 1960, we went to Germany for 3 years. And that was a very good, very nice experience, really. I enjoyed my military service.
That's great.
And she enjoyed being in Germany. We had it was a 3-year tour, and so we were authorized military housing. But they didn't have any military housing open when we got there. Actually, we got some concurrent travel, which was a little bit of a subterfuge, I guess you could call. When I found out where I was going, it was the 3rd Infantry Division at Würzburg, Germany. We contacted the Surgeon General's office, or Division Surgeon's office there, and about what, in order to get concurrent travel, you had to have a place to live for your family and at your station of assignment. And so I got a letter back or a telegram with an address, and it was signed by one of my fellow interns who had left a little earlier than I had. And so we had an address to go to Germany, and so we went on this same plane with a whole plane load of, it was a Constellation full of dependents, wives and their children, and some military officers or military personnel. And when we got there, then we found out that the address was an address. That's it. There was no place to live there. It was just an address so we could get our concurrent travel. So we lived for 1 month in an old German Army BOQ in one big room with two kids, one 2 years and one 3 weeks.
6 weeks.
No, it's even more. 2 months, I guess it was. 2 months, 3 months. Anyway, on the second floor of a BOQ, and the ladies' restroom was on the first floor. So she had to go down to the first floor to get to do diapers, and we were cloth diapers. Didn't have disposal diapers then. It was before that time. And so then